Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Finu to my channel. Hi, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about few of the new skincare products which I tried and I really, really love. All the products are Indian except for one brand and everything is kind of affordable. So yeah, let's get started. So let's start off with cleansers, and I have a lot of favorite new cleansers. So I have four cleansers, three of them I have now and one is completely over, so I just put a picture of it. And so first one I've been really enjoying these days is this Requel Oil Control Face Wash. I've used, you know, a lot of it, like you can see, and I'm really, really enjoying it. It's a very good face wash. If you have oily skin, you can definitely give this a try. So one thing I really like about this is that usually when people say it's for oily skin or oil control, they end up putting sulfate surfactants in the face wash, which strips your skin like a lot compared to the normal mild surfactants. So this has really mild surfactants and I really enjoy this. Now next one is, I use this in my morning skincare routine as well. This is the Dermaweave Hydra Cleanser, beautiful cleanser. So this is the only product which I was saying is not Indian. So this is an Australian brand. Really, really beautiful cleanser, such a hydrating formula. This would be a really good cleanser for your morning routine. If you have like oily skin or if you have dry skin, you can use it morning and night. So such a like beautiful formula. I really, really like it. No fragrance, no sulfates, no paraben, nothing in this. So I really enjoy this cleanser. So next one I have is from Forever Earth Skincare. This is their purifying willow bark foaming face wash. I fell in love with this from the minute I started using this. So I've been really enjoying the products I tried from this brand. There's one more product which I'll be talking about in the later part of the video. That product actually made me curious to try more, and the owner was really sweet to send me more. So this is their Willow Bark Foaming Face Wash. Absolutely love it. It has tea tree oil also. It has willow bark, I don't know if you guys know it. So it has salicin. I hope I'm pronouncing it right, which is a derivative of salicylic acid. Sorry guys, I was wrong here. Actually, salicylic acid is derived from salicin. So it's extremely anti-inflammatory and antibacterial. So I've been enjoying, like you can see, I've used a lot of it and I've been really enjoying this. The fourth product is the Tribe Concepts Face Brightening Cleanser. So it's basically a powder. It's an organic powder type of formula. So I did a video with them on my Instagram, and in that video, I don't know why people felt it's very harsh. It's just pure powder. It's like as soft as your like normal pond's powder would be. So once you mix it with water and you apply it, it's quite gentle and I've been loving it. It's actually over, and I put that dabba aside to show in the video, but my mom wanted to use it for something, so she took it like without telling me, so I don't have the box now. It's like in the rasoi somewhere. So yeah, that's one. So next we have makeup remover. So first one I've been really enjoying is this, the Inveda Stubborn Makeup Cleansing Oil. So it is almost over. I really don't know if you can see, so it's like almost done, and it does remove makeup. I really, really like this. I really like the oils which has, like it has olive oil, has grapeseed oil, jojoba oil, castor seed oil, hazel seed oil, rose hip oil. So you know, really good to remove makeup, like basically all natural oil type of formula, but with little, what do you call that? Surfactants? I don't think it's called surfactants, is it? I forgot the name, bro. I'm not supposed to do skincare videos. Next one, this actually I've been only trying since past 10 to 15, not even 15, like I think 10 days. So this is the Earth Rhythm Cleansing Balm in Matcha Green Tea. I love it, dude. So I've been trying to get my hands on a balm which doesn't have polyethylene. So I used to love the Clinique Take the Day of Cleansing Balm. Really, really love it. Like it does the job, okay? And it never affected my skin. I really used to love it, but it has polyethylene. So I don't want to personally recommend it to somebody, but like, you know, because it has its own side effects of affecting the environment. I'm like, you know, why like, you know, talk about it when we have better things. So I've been really loving this. I actually spoke about this on my stories also. I think does the job really well, cleanses your makeup off. Like I use this half potion and I've been really loving this. So next one, which I told you previously that I'll be talking about from Forever Earth Skincare, is this acne spot treatment. Basically this is a dry out acne treatment. So if you have like any fresh acne, you can apply this on it and it dries it out really quickly. So, and it works works, you guys. Like sometimes our acne comes in, doesn't go away for 7 days, 8 days, but this will make sure it dries down at minimum at least two, three days for sure. So, and I actually noticed, I don't know, it's maybe in my head, but I did notice that when I use this spot treatment, so the scar which is left behind by the pimple is also very minimal. It could be just like my, you know, skin, or it actually does that with some of the ingredients in it. So really loving this. I would definitely recommend this. Is just $350, dude, and you get a lot of it. I've used it easily more than I can't even count. I did like few weeks back breakout like really, really badly, so you know, that was my savior. Then next we have I'm going to talk about the brand here. So next we have three products from Sugandha which have been absolutely loving. So one is this Sugandha Aloe Green Tea Gel. Oh my god, I've been loving this moisturizer. So I have the one which is scented, basically, which has lavender essential oil, but they started selling unscented version, so I would definitely recommend that, because like if you get something which doesn't have it, then why would you use something which has, you know, oil? And but you know, it didn't irritate my skin. It's the last ingredients, very, very minimal, didn't irritate my skin, and I've been loving this. It's very watery, so if my skin is little normal or dry, it's never dry, but when it is normal, I use this like a serum and then go in with my moisturizer. Then the other two products are these serums. So one is a BHA and the next one is their niacinamide. So again, I don't have much to say. These are like, you know, as basic as they can be. A BHA, salicylic acid, 2%, really good to exfoliate your skin from within. And then niacinamide does 100 million things for your skin. Really good, 10% is the good percentage of niacinamide, and I've been really enjoying this. So actually a couple of people, you know, texted me saying that, because, you know, we compare everything to the Ordinary, because Ordinary is like the skincare, set their standard there with the price point and the ingredient list. So somebody's told me that, you know, it has brown color, so maybe it's bad, but that's not the case, you guys. Every formulation is different. Like this one has green tea in it, so that maybe change the color of the formula. We never know, like, you know, formulation can happen and, you know, colors might change. Niacinamide doesn't have to always be white. So again, I really like it. Niacinamide and green tea is a really good combination. It has centella, it has glycerin, sodium hyaluronate, which is hyaluronic acid. I mean, like, I don't think I could ask for more in a niacinamide. Really loving it. So next one is this Eclat Eye Serum. So it has caffeine, it has retinol. I think it is a really good under eye serum. Especially a lot of people ask me something for dark circles. I mean, dark circles is really complicated to treat, but you can definitely start using this eye cream. So the retinol will help, you know, rejuvenate the skin a lot quicker, and maybe you would see a difference in your dark circles. I really like the ingredients in this. So it's extremely hydrating, it has caffeine, which is like very de-puffing, so if you have very puffy eyes, it would help for that. It has green tea extract, etc. So I think it's a really good product to buy for an under eye serum. So I've been loving it. Like, I don't know if you can see, I did use like a lot from here to here. Like for a serum that quickly, I went to it. Matlab, I did use a lot. Actually, me and my mom both are using it. So I do have a discount code for this. I think I don't have for anything else. So you can check it out if you want. Like, I completely always forget to give you my codes. So I'll put it in the description. I think it's Akanksha 10 or Akanksha K. I'm not sure. It'll be in the description. If you really want to check out some good under eye serum, then you can definitely give this one a try. So we just have two more left. I think that would make 15 products. So I have more 15 products, I think, easily, which I want to talk about. So I just thought I'll divide this video into part 1 and part 2, obviously part 2 and part 3, because I already have one you know, skincare video previously which I did, so you can definitely check that one out. I'll link it here or in the description bar, wherever. So yeah, let me know if you want to see another part. I'll maybe give a 1-2 week gap and then post one more favorite video. So next one is the Thrive Concepts Face Glow Mask. I've been loving this one. Like, you can see it's over, almost over, near to less over. Like, I really like it. I use it at least once a week. They do suggest 2-3 times, but at least one, like minimum one time I use it. And sometimes I use it twice as well, if I remember. But once for sure, and I've been really liking it. Like, every time I wear this mask, I've been like enjoying it. I really like how it feels, like my skin feels. It's really nice. I really like it. I've been enjoying that a lot. So last one is a sunscreen, and this is from Derma about this, the Pure Zinc Matte Sunscreen Gel. Now, again, this also does have fragrance, but it's not as strong as like for the niacinamide. Only the niacinamide has such potent smell. Like I use the AHA, that's also fine. This also is like fine compared to everything, but I wish, yeah, like it's such an active based skincare brand. I just wish they didn't have that one ingredient which is like the perfume. If it didn't have perfume, I would literally like try using the entire range. Like the entire range, I would recommend it to you guys because the ingredients are so good. I just wish the fragrance was not there. I wish that there would be a moment where, you know, we can send them 100 emails, give them more perfume, because it's such a good ingredient based brand. So anyway, this is the Pure Zinc Matte Sunscreen Gel. I always just use physical sunscreen because that is the only thing which suits my skin. Chemical sunscreen makes me break out so badly. I don't know why, like, you know, some reaction to the skin. So this is something I've been using recently. This is my second tube and I've been really enjoying it. The white cast is very minimal, like very very minimal compared to other sunscreen gel. So yeah, that sums up this video. I hope you found some product which you've been looking for or waiting for a review. So make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell and comment below and tell me if you like any of these products or using it or any product which you want me to review so that I will try and review it. And that's it for today's video. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.